Sup guys, I'm Kel, Red Zone Rogue, and today we have, as you can obviously see right here, a Return of the Dragon Emperor booster box opening. This will be just a single booster box. I don't know which one I'm going to open up yet. They're both Return of the Dragon Emperor, obviously. But yeah, I'm going to open up one of them here, and then I'm going to open up another one in another video, so it's not all at once. And for the sake of brevity, we're not going to read over every single card and all that type of stuff. Also, the boxes did come with a couple Captain Hooks. Each box came with a, you know, full art promo Captain Hook, which is pretty sweet. It looks nice, as you can see right here. And we do have some pink-ass sleeves to go in case we get, like, an Uber or something really sweet. So, yeah, got the sleeves ready. Anyway, let's pick a box. Let's see. Right. Sure, let's do it. Jeez, guys, the Forcible Company does not mess around. The plastic is, like, really pretty strong plastic. A lot stronger than you'd think. So let's take a look at the box before I open it up, lift it up. We have, you know, all the standard stuff. This box is the same as, you know, basically from Curse of the Frozen Casket onward. And the Battle for Ataraxia box was very similar. Here we have all your standard, you know, Force of Will, Shinjikaku, Tokyo, Return of the Dragon Emperor, all this good stuff. It does have the little marker on the side, so you can, you know, line up all your boxes on your shelf or whatever. Anyway, let's lift it up. Let's see what we got. Oh, nice. Oh, sweet, we got the Prisia topper. That's pretty cool. That's what she looks like in all of her glory. We'll go ahead and set that here. Move this, you know, back a little ways. Let's see. Like that? Yeah, that looks good. Inside also still has this alchemical pentagram thing. It's not really a pentagram. You know what I mean. And then we also got this little booklet. So let's take a look in the booklet. Let's see. End of Fates. Looks nice. I wonder if there's any spelling errors in this one. And then inside we have Welcome to Return to the Dragon Emperor. It's got some new mechanics. We got some, you know, some deck ideas, stuff like that with Kaguya here. Got some, like, lore or whatever. Jump into action with your friends. Sealed format. Actually, it's not lore. It's sealed format. There you go. And he's got, like, some Uber errors. Maybe we'll get one. Both of these boxes, I assume, are from the same case. So there's a decent chance we could get an Uber rare. Well, not decent, but you know what I mean. Then we have, this is the artwork that was on the poster I was going to talk about. Yeah, look at that. There's Sylvia right there. So that'll be interesting. Maybe we'll get another Sylvia card. And then join the league. Oh, dude, it's, whatchamacallem, Yogg-Sothoth. That's cool, I like that art. And then here we have the back. Any spelling errors? I don't know. Okay, let's get to a booster pack. Alright, so here is a booster pack in all of its glory. Let's see what it looks like. It's a nice packaging. I like the art on it. It looks really good. You have Lapis in the middle, Gil Alhama'at, Prisia. She looks like she's like, you know, tip of the hat to you. Good old Kaguya here. And then just your standard stuff. 10 cards out of 105 from the whole set. And that 5 does include the stones. So yeah, let's do this. Alright, so before I go over the cards, this does come with all the QR codes, as you would know, but I'm going to remove all the QR codes before I go over the cards, so we won't have to deal with the QR code bit. So yeah, let's do that right now. Alright, so the first card is Cryptid of Tenacious Fire. And like I said, I'm not really going to go over all of the cards, like what they do and stuff. You know, for the sake of time. The Insane Dark Hatter. This guy looks really cool. We got Memory to Memoria, even. Miracle Millennium Medicine. Oh, I love the alliteration on that one. Oh, we got a water kimono of 12 parts. So I'm going to keep track of how many water kimonos we get. We're going to put that, like, I don't know, maybe right here or something. We have the Fire Magic Stone? The Magic Stones are usually on the end. All right, so we got the Magic Stone here. And then we got, oh, nice. Starting off strong, we got a foil. It's really hard to tell. But she is foil, trust me. Foil Viola Obsidian Dragon Princess. Which is pretty sweet. So we got our first super rare. I'm going to put that, I don't know, probably going to do something like, here, move this. We're going to do something like, you know, rares, super rares, and then all the full arts, perhaps. And then maybe ruler can go up here or something. I don't know. We got Guardian of Altaian Law. Secret Messenger of the Mikage. She's like really going at that string. And then we have a Dragon Power is our rare. Cool, so yeah, once again, gonna put the rares here. supers and then full arts, and then all the kimonos are gonna go up top. We're gonna have a kimono count. Kimono count one. Alright, we got the Dark Sleeping Dormouse. He looks cool. He looks pretty nuts. We have this cute little dragon, Tiny Alabaster Drake. And we have another Dark Sleeping Dormouse, Cryptid of Tenacious Fire, Fiery Fox of Reincarnation. Art looks really nice. Man, the art looks really sweet. Valentina, the Twilight Passion, another super rare. Pretty good. Already two super rares. And, you know, the art looks fantastic. It's very, very cool. I like how she's got her her thingy right here. It's a hydromonica. Maybe. Perhaps. Got a fire magic stone. Ooh, is this a foil one? Yeah. It is. We got Sisse, Prissia's Barrier. We got Research, which I think is actually a pretty good card. And then we have a Salamander, the Spirit of Fire. It's a rare. Alright, so our foil is Zero's Wrath, which... Dude, the art looks so good. I know I just said that, but this artist, Lack, follow him on Twitter. He is a fantastic artist. That looks very good. We have the Night Moon Blossom, which is a flower and is also a resonator, so it can attack, I guess. Spirit of Sacred Rains. The Insane Dark Hatter, who looks nuts as always. We have another Memory to Memoria. We have another Fire Magic Stone. It's all Fire Magic Stones. And we have, oh, here we go. Full Art Kaguya Millennium Princess. Well, that did not take long to get our Full Art Ruler. And then the other side has the Super Crying Kaguya Tears of the Moon, which is so sad. There is alternate art for the regular and the full art. So the full art has like her like mega crying, and the regular one just has like her regular crying. But this is a really sweet card to pull. I do want to make a Kaguya deck, and we are keeping track of the kimonos. So yeah, that's really sweet. So we're going to put that, I don't know, up here, I guess, over Olivia's face. And then we have Charlotte's Water Dragon Technique, which is pretty hilarious. We have the Gnome, the Spirit of Earth. And then our rare is the Blazer, or just Blazer, Prisoner of Flame, who is a zombie dragon. And also, he looks badass. Looks like something from Diablo, or maybe Dark Souls, I don't know. One of those. So we got a foil Tiny Alabaster Dragon, Moonlit Treasure Tree, Mermaid of Life-Giving. I mean, that's like totally the, you know, Little Mermaid pose thing going on. We have Viola's Machinations. Either way, it looks really sweet. I don't know if this card's good enough for Alhama'at. I do want to make an Alhama'at deck. I'm pretty stoked for that. We have Vengeful Ataractian Wizard, and then we have another super rare my list, the First Flame. It's pretty good. I think he's actually pretty good. And then we have a, what is this one? A Darkness Magic Stone? Oh, it's like a foil Darkness Magic Stone. Nice. And then we got the Alabaster Dragon Princess's Rescue. The Conquered of Saints and Beasts, which is pretty cool. And then our final card is Kaguya's Decision. And I forgot to take out the QR code, but no big deal. Kaguya's Decision is the rare, which is it's an alright rare. Is it foil? Nah. But pretty good. Alright, so our foil is a water kimono in 12 parts, which is hilarious. That's sweet. I hope to get more than four. Knowing Force of Will packs, probably just going to get four, but we'll see. We have the Divine Bird of Adirectia, Apprentice Were-Rabbit. She looks pretty cool. We have the Unleashed Dragonoid, Fallen Saint. And then our rare is the Magic Stone of Ebonhome, which is pretty cool. This is Gil Lapis's rare Magic Stone. So this is pretty sweet. And then we got an uncommon foil, Shield of the Nephilim. Wait, it's weird that we got, like, two foils. Yeah. I mean, I guess it's not that weird. It means we got the uncommon as foil. We have a Rising Firestrike, Kingdom of the Spirits, and then our rare is Schrodinger's Observation, which is pretty good. So, yeah. Alright, so we have a foil Erasure, which is a pretty good card. Destroy a non-magic stone card. Not too bad. We have Alabaster Dragon Knight, Dark March Hare. He looks pretty silly. We have Searing Dead. Or is it Dread? Dead. It's totally dead. We have a Rapid Shot, which looks awesome. We have another Fire Magic Stone. And we have, nice! We have a Full Art Viola Obsidian Dragon Princess. I'm pretty stoked. Like I said, I want to make an Alhama'at deck, and, you know, she's obviously going straight in. And the full art just looks gorgeous. This has to be one of my favorite arts in the whole set. I really like Viola's, like, character design. Kind of like Egyptian-y looking, sort of. I don't know. Either way, I think it looks really cool. So, putting the full arts here. And then we got, what is this? Kingdom of the Spirits. Okay, how the hell do you say his name? Buer? Bauer? Okay, hold on. It's like Buer? Great President of Hell? I don't know. Something like that. And then we have Dwarf Time. Dwarf Time's a pretty cool card. Let you take an extra turn, but then you die, and then your opponent can pay some... I don't know. You can read what it does. It's pretty good. There's some things you can do to cancel the losing the game type things and whatnot, but pretty good all overall. I think it is pretty cool, and I hope to see it played somewhere, at least. Alright, so we have a foil Miracle Millennium Medicine. The card all about alliteration. Earthfallen Giant. I don't know why I immediately went to Crestfallen. Dragon of Fire and Wind. Water Wind Knight. She looks pretty cool. We have Millium as a dragon. Roarin'. Millium's Roar is the name of the card. And we have a rare Kaguya Stone of Sorrow. Pretty sweet. Getting rare stones is always good. Then we have a foil uncommon. The Fiery Soldier of My List. We have another Buer Bauer. We have Charlotte's Water Dragon Technique. And then we have our rare, the Fury of the Obsidian Dragon, which has really cool art. Yeah, nice. Alright, so we have Memory to Memoria, a foil one. We got this cute little demon guy, Demon Orderly. What is this? Sprinting Flame Horse. We got a Ponyta. We got a Windclad Elf, which I think might be good enough for Wanderer Elves. I don't know yet. We'll see. I don't know. It's hard to tell. We got a Dragonoid Jailer, and then a Water Magic Stone with this sparkly turtle that reminds me of the crab from Moana, if you've seen Moana. And we have a foil Fury of the Obsidian Dragon, which is pretty cool. Foil rare. Got this Gnome Bro. Alice's World of Madness. Resonators gain -200/-200, and it's an addition. So that's actually pretty good. And then we have... what is this? Rain of Light. That's really, really pretty on this. Alright, so we have the Insane Dark Hatter foil. It looks cool. We have another Zero's Wrath, which looks awesome as well. Erasure. There's a Swirling Demon Dimension. There's a lot of alliteration in this set. Forest Spirit. A Darkness Magic Stone, which looks sweet. Ooh, we got a Full Art Super Rare. So this is Aya, God of Water. It looks really cool. I like his, like, almost Spike Spiegel hairdo. Yeah. Nice. And the full arts and the texture is still really, really nice. And then we have a Shield of the Nephilim, a Glistening Chick. Yes, that's the name of the card. And then our rare is Spinning Myths. Nice. With a good old Gilgamesh here. And then Kaguya in the far background. Alright, so we got a Foil Forest Spirit. Looks pretty cool. I like the coloring on this. It looks really, like, I don't know, stylized. We got another Ponyta. Windclad Elf, which, once again, I didn't point this out, but looks very nice. I mean, that could be said for a lot of these cards, but yeah. Dragonoid Jailer. Another Zero's Wrath. A Light Magic Stone? Yeah, cool. Looks pretty good. And we got a Foil Schrodinger's Observation. Very nice. It actually looks pretty good in person. You can hardly tell on the camera, but it does look nice. And then we have a Research! Alabaster Dragon Princess's Rescue, and then a Will-O-The-Wisp, which I think is a pretty interesting card. It's just a 100-100 for two with Barrier. When you play it, hold on, focus. You play it, you get a draw card, and whenever it's dealt damage, you gain that much life. It's an interesting card. I don't know if it'll see play, but it might, so I don't know, we'll see. Alright, foil Dark March Hare. We got a mermaid of whatchamacallit, life giving. It's difficult to read through the camera. We have Viola's Machinations, Vengeful, Ataractian Wizard, Divine Bird of Ataractia. We have Mystia, Manager of the Treasury, and I think this is a super rare. Yeah, it is. Nice. Pretty cool. Goes with, you know, good old Kaguya there. Super rare. And we got a foil wind magic stone. Once again, it's difficult to tell that it's foil, but kind of see the shin there. The shinning. We have a Millia Bond, or Millennia Bond, not Millia Bond. Unending Hatred. Dude, that looks sweet. She's gonna get him with her stank hand. And then we have a End of Days, which also looks sweet. Just a massive monsters popping out. Kind of reminds me of, I don't know. I want to say Berserk, but I don't know why. Anyway, moving on. Alright, so we got a foil Ponyta. We have a Viola's Machinations. I'm going to say that twice every single time, just because I think I'm pronouncing it wrong. I might be. Vengeful Ataractian Wizard. Divine Bird of Ataractia. Apprentice Were-Rabbit. And then we have... What the hell? This is a Shadow Token? This looks sweet. Like, seriously. This is awesome. I don't know what's going on. So I assume there's like a flip side. Yeah, look at that dude. 500-500 Shadow Token, and this one's like a... 500-500 as well. Okay, I don't know where to put this. I don't know, whatever. I'll just put it with the other stuff. We have a foil Sisse Prissia's Barrier, uncommon. So this took the place of the rare? Did I already go through the rare? Hold on. Common Camellia. Okay, whatever. We got this. This is what we got for an uncommon. And then we have a Fallen Angel, which looks really cool. I think the angel cards are actually really good. There's like Rachel, this guy, and then there's another one maybe? Oh, it's the Demon Orderly that interacts with them. Either way, they're all really cool. We have the Fiery Soldier on my list, and then another Rain of Light. Yeah, so I guess the token took the place of like the foil rare? Is it like a foil token? No? Okay, well, it's still pretty cool. Alright, so our foil common is the Divine Bird of Ataractia. We have the Vengeful Ataractian Wizard, another Divine Bird of Ataractia. We got a lot of Ataractia shit going on here. Apprentice Were-Rabbit. We have the, what is this, Unleashed Dragonoid. We have an Ancient Magic Stone. This is Alhama'at's Magic Stone, which is pretty cool. And then we have a foil, what is this, Black Hole of the Spirit World. Nice. I mean, it looks really nice. We have a Glistening Chick, another Black Hole of the Spirit World, and then another Will-O-The-Wisp. Cool. Alright, so our foil common is the Demon Orderly, which is the one that I was talking about earlier. We have the Unleashed Dragonoid, the one that I was talking about that goes well with all the angel dudes. Got Fallen Saint, Earth Fallen Giant, Dragon of Fire and Wind, and then we have a... Dude, I have not seen these. We have an Elf Token. So, these are really nice looking. Yeah, these are probably the best looking elf tokens so far, and I like the ones that came in the Vingolf set, too. Sweet. I hope to get at least one of these per box, so I'll have two. So, yeah, that'll be nice. And then our foil uncommon is a really cool looking one. It's the two Dragon Princesses. Already got a bunch of her already. I've not seen you yet. Pretty cool card. I imagine if I'm playing an Alhama'at deck, I may or may not play this. I'm not sure. Anyway, we have Millennia Bond, Unending Hatred, and then a Spinning Myths. Nice. All right, got a foil Milliam's Roar, Wind Rabbit, something like that. Another Milliam's Roar, another Demon Orderly, a Ponyta. So I gotta come up with names of these. I don't remember the name of the Moana. I'm just going to call this Moana Crab, even though it's not even a crab. We have Gnome, the Spirit of Earth. Foil. Pretty good. We have a Manservant to the Water God. Uncommon. We have a Guardian of Altaian Law. And then we have a Fiery Bird of Reincarnation. Is a rare. Nice. Alright, Vengeful Ataractian Wizard. Fallen Spirit. Giant Bro. We have Dragon of Fire and Wind, Wind Water Knight. What did I call before? I don't know, man. We have Memoria of Reincarnation, which is Prissia's rare magic stone, which is pretty good. I think I probably should get at least one of all of the stones. Well, we'll see. We have a foil Millennia Bond, which looks really nice. Poor old Feet Sing. We have Alhama'at's Purge. Like, just purge the fuck out of him. We have the First Moon, and then Prisia's Leap, which is actually pretty good. It lets your dudes attack again, which, yeah. Target J Resonator you control may attack up to X times this turn, until end of turn attacking does not cause that card to rest. So you can just, like, machine gun them with your card. Seems strong. Alright, so we have a foil Water Wind Knight. That is what it's called. I'm going to get it right. I totally didn't mean that to rhyme. We have a Windclad Elf. We have a Dragonoid Jailer. Zero's Wrath. Erasure. Darkness Magic Stone. A foil Spinning Myths. Which is a rare. So that's pretty sweet. And then we got... what is this? Secret Messenger of the Makage. And then a Sise. And then a Rachel Nephilim Commander. This is a pretty cool rare. This is the one I was talking about. She's like an ancient angel demon. And when she... when it enters your field, you can put a demon with one from your graveyard into your field, so you can pick the demon orderly. She does some other stuff too. Pretty cool card. Pretty cool art, if you ask me to. So yeah, pretty happy about that. Alright, so we have Dragon of Fire and Wind. What is this? Swirling Demon Dimension. Looks pretty sweet. What is it? Forest Spirit. Kaguya's Pictorial Scroll. It's the first one of those we've gotten. Alabaster Dragon Knight. We have a Light Magic Stone. And then behind that, I have a Foil Gilgamesh Immortal Hunter. This is a super rare. He's pretty sweet. He looks pretty badass, too. Yeah, nice. And then we got Research! I know I said gots. The Alabaster Dragon, Princess's Rescue, and then a Moonview Rabbit is our rare. It's pretty cute. Alright, so we have a foil Viola's Machinations. It looks really nice. And I know I say that all the time, but, I mean, it does. I say it because it's true. Milliam's Roar, Demon Orderly, Ponyta, Windclad Elf, we got Moana Turtle, we have a foil Fiery Bird of Reincarnation. I believe this is a rare. It's a foil rare. Pretty sweet. We have a Burning Pot. It's an angry bunch of food. Got Swiftness and First Strike. That's pretty cool. We have a Heavenly Ox, and then a rare is another Door of Time. Nice. Alrighty, so our foil is the Spirit of Sacred Rains. It's really pretty. We have a Kaguya's Pictorial Scroll, Alabaster Dragon Knight, Dark March Hare, Searing Dead, Light Magic Stone. Make sure it's not foil. Ooh, nice. We have a Full Art Fury of the Obsidian Dragon. This is sweet looking. I was gonna say, it's been a while since we got a full art. I think we're due for one. It's a very cool looking one too. I'm all down. We got a Black Hole of the Spirit World, Alhama'at's Purge, and then a rare Fiery Bird of Reincarnation. We got a lot of these. I might have a place of them already. Yeah, not too bad though. I'd like to point out we only have two water kimonos so far. Come on, box. I know you got, nine more in you. Probably not. Kaguya's Pictorial Scroll foil. Then we got this Dragon of Fire and Wind, Water Wind Knight, Millions Roar, Demon Orderly. You didn't see that. We have a Darkness Magic Stone, and then a foil Valentina the Twilight Passion, which is nice. I still want a full art one of her because it would just look awesome. And then we have below her a Secret Messenger of the Makage. To say Prissy's Barrier, and then a Schrodinger, the Cat in Flux. It is simultaneously alive and dead. Is it a zombie? No, it's a shadow. Bummer. I was hoping it'd be a zombie. Common foil is Swirling Demon Dimension, Erasure, Swirling Demon Dimension, Forest Spirit, Kaguya's Pictorial Scroll. I got a lot of those now, all of a sudden. Wind Magic Stone, and then a Moonview Rabbit. Shiny one. Shiny rabbit. Got a Concord of Saints and Beast, Rising Fire Strike. Sounds like a... I also have the Prissy's Leap. Rising Fire Strike sounds like an attack from like Street Fighter or something. Yeah. Foil Searing Dead. Got another Dormouse guy. A Cryptid. Fiery Fox. Moonlit Treasure Tree. It's a tree. It hurts you if you attack it. It like whacks you back. You have a Moana Turtle. We have a... Oh! So this is our ruler. Milliam the Sacred Dragon. So this is our non-full art ruler. Here is his other side. What is this? Milliam, Successor of the Dragon Crest. Pretty cool. I think he's a pretty good card. We'll have to see. He's like not one of the ones I was really excited about, but I'm pretty happy to get him anyway. So we'll put them up here. You know what? I'm gonna put Kaguya on top. I'm sorry, Milliam. But full art Kaguya, cooler. Anyway, we have a Fallen Angel. Pretty good. I already mentioned that before. I think it's a good card. Fiery Stone on my list. And a Reincarnation, which is just looks cool. Nice. All right, two rulers down. Still hope for an Uber. We shall see. Apprentice Were-Rabbit, Dragonoid, Fallen Old Man, Earth Fallen, all the Fallens, man. Moana Turtle. Ooh, nice. A full art Door of Time. This is gorgeous. This box is definitely telling me that I need to do a Kaguya deck. But I don't think this would be good with that Kaguya. I think the other Kaguya would be better. The one that can cancel automatic abilities? What does it cancel? I don't remember what it cancels, but it basically can cancel this. I think it's an automatic ability. Anyway, we got, what is this? Manservant, Guardian of Altan Law, and then we have a Undyne, the Spirit of Water. I actually think this card's pretty good. So, yeah, pretty happy to get it. And it looks also really good. What does it do again? When it enters your field, you may return target resonator and opponent controls with 12 cost or less than or equal to the number of water magic stones you control. Yeah, that's an okay tempo card. We have a foil, Night Moon Blossom. I'm going to call this the Painful Flower because it deals 300 damage. It deals more damage than some, like, resonators with, like, weapons and stuff, which is pretty funny. We got Rapid Shot, another Painful Flower. I'm calling it that now. A Spirit of Sacred Rain. The Insane Dark Hatter, Wind Magic Stone, a foil, Super Rare Mylas, the First Flame, that's pretty cool. We got a First Moon, Burning Pot, and another Rachel Nephilim Commander, nice. I do want to get a full playset of her, because I want to mess around with some angel-y, demon-y stuff. And a foil, Rapid Shot, which still looks really sweet, Memory to Memoria, Miracle Millennia Medicine. Oh my god, dude. Two in a row. Memory to Memoria and Miracle Millennia Medicine. Just all M's all the time. Yes! Number three! Water Kimono of 12 parts. We got this little dragon dude. We have a Fire Magic Stone. We have a foil End of Days. Still looks pretty cool. We got this big ox dude. Ox Bellows. The two Dragon Princesses. And then we have another Moonbeam Rabbit. Alright, we got another fisty giant. Just laying the fist down. We have a Dark March Hare, a Burning Zombie, Rapid Shot. What did I say it was? I forgot already. Look at the memory of like a fish. It's like pain flower, painful flower. I don't know. Something like that. It's the hurt flower. We have a foil blazer, zombie blazer. And then, was this a foil? No. It's kind of looked like a foil. Conquered of Saints and Beasts. We have another Tiger Uppercut. And a Reincarnation. I know I called the Tiger Lily one Tiger Uppercut. What can I call this one? Rising Fire Strike. I'll think it's like more like a Shoryuken. It sounds like a Shoryuken. Like Rising Fire Strike. Does that sound like that? Yeah. Alright, so we got Foil Little Mermaid. Blue Dragon Bro. Angry Zero. Erasure. Swirling Demon Dimension. Just all of the alliteration all the time. We have a foil Fallen Angel. Pretty sweet. Yeah. Pretty cool. I like it. Wait, this is uncommon. Get over with the other uncommons. We have the double Dragon Girls. Another Fallen Angel. That's pretty cool. And then just a regular Blazer. Just regular Blazer. We have foil Old Man. We have, Spirit of Sacred Rain. I think the second one I've gotten. We got Johnny Depp. We have Memory to Memoria. Okay, that can't be a coincidence. Second time in a row, Memory to Memoria and Miracle Millennium Medicine. I don't know, man. We have a full art Fiery Bird of Reincarnation. It's gorgeous. Look at that, it looks sweet. I've got like four of them, or five of them now. We have, this you know, Hidden Valley thing. We have beer. And we got
End of Days.
Nice, we have a foil Windclad Elf. Yeah, I'm happy for that. If I want to use it in my Wanderer elves, then definitely glad that it's foil. We have a Fiery Fox. We have a Painful Tree that will whip you. A Little Mermaid. Ooh, another Viola Obsidian Dragon Princess. Nice, the third one in the box. I'm very happy about that. This is the second Ancient Magic Stone. I think this one's foil. Yeah. I just need Alhama'at now. Come on, Force of Will. Give me Alhama'at. Give me an Uber Alhama'at. And a Glistening Trick. All the glistening. We have a Black Hole of the Spirit World. Damn, look at all those people. They're just getting totally wrecked. And then a Sylph the Spirit of Wind is a rare. And I forgot to take away the QR code. Alright, so we have a Foil Unleashed Dragonoid. Can they come up with the name of this? Like, Flex Bracers? I don't know. Ah, sweet! Another Water Kimono. Kimono Count 4. Kimono Con 4. We have a Dormouse and this Burning Guy and... ooh, super rare. We have Almirius, Summoner of Spirits? Yeah. Yeah, that's pretty cool. It's nice to see Almirius again. And then, it's weird that the super rare was before the... I don't know how these packs go yet. We got a foil Magic Stone, which looks really nice. We have a Dragon Magic, big ol' Gnome Nose, and a rare Undyne Spirit of the Water. Alright, we got a foil Giving Tree, I'm just gonna call it that. Forest Spirit, Kaguya's Pictorial Scroll. We got a lot of these. I wish they were all kimonos. We have an Alabaster Dragon Bro, Dark March Hair, a Light Magic Stone. And we foil Sylph the Spirit of the Wind, which is a rare. It's got a foil rare. Pretty good. A Fiery Soldier of Mylest, Millennia Bond, and a Demon Captain. What is this? Elagos? This card is sweet. This is the one that I was thinking about. I mistakenly said Fallen Angel. This is the one I was thinking about. When it enters your field, put target Demon Resonator with 3 or less from your graveyard to your field. Yeah, so you can play this, and then it can get Rachel, because she's a Demon Angel. And then when Rachel comes into play, she can get the other guy. Yeah, pretty cool. Also, it's got really nice art. So, yeah, full art one of this would be really sweet, too. Anyway, let's keep going. Alright, so we have a Foil Apprentice Were-Rabbit. Foil Bunny. We got a Burning Fox. We got a Giving Tree. And a Little Mermaid. We have a Viola's Machinations. We have... oh, nice! I totally forgot this was even in the set. Blackheart Alice. Super rare. Yeah, she's cool. I don't know if she's that good, but she looks really cool. So that counts for something. Aw, dude! Full Art Ancient Magic Stone. Nice. We got like 3 of them. Sweet, I'm gonna get a playset of these between these 2 boxes, probably. We have a Alice's World of Madness, Shield of the Nephilim, and a Schrodinger. Nice. Alright, we got a Foil Firefox! We have some Burning Zombie. Machine Gun, What's-Her-Face. Got a Pain Flower. Spirit of the Whatevers. Wind Magic Stone. Ooh, a Full Art Salamander, the Spirit of Fire. I like his, like, paunch. He's, like, got a big head and a paunch. Nice. A, Unending Hatred, Manservant of the Water Jabronis, and a Sylph of the Wind Jabronis. Alright, we have another Foil Ponyta. It's gotta be, like, a second one at least. Viola's Machinations, the Angry Ataractian Bro, another Ataractian thing, Apprentice Were-Rabbit. Ooh, nice, Ryula Alabaster Dragon Princess. I was wondering where she was. I was hoping to at least get one of each of all the super rares, and I think we... what? Okay. We have a Azathoth Hunter of Reality Full Art. I totally forgot these were even in the set. I would have probably been like, when the hell is my Curse of the Frozen Casket Full Art? Well, here it is. Got Azathoth. That's pretty sweet. He still looks like a Persona character, if you ask me. And you didn't, but I'm telling you anyway. And then we have a Alhama'at's Purge, the First Moon, and a Dragon Power. Alright, final pack of the box. Let's see what we get. Alright, so Foil Dragonoid Jailer. This massive alliteration card. Another Water Kimono. 5. Nice. I know you can't see that. 5. There we go. We have a little dragon, a little mouse. We have Aya, God of Water. Super rare. Nice. Pretty cool. We have a foil Moana Turtle. a Alice's World of Madness, the Shield of the Nephilim, and our final card is a Demon Captain Elagos. Pretty cool. Alright, so for the recap, I got one of all the stones except for the Millium Stone, which is kind of weird. And I actually got three of the Ancient Magic, the Alhama'at Stone, which is pretty cool. One of which is going to be full art when I go over the full arts in a second. Throw this up here. Here you can see all the super rares that are not full art. Pretty good. We got three Violas, one of which is full art, and some other full art stuff as well. So let's go over full art, so I stop saying full art. Also, here's Millium. We got him too. He's pretty cool. So for a full ruler, or full art ruler, we have Kaguya, Millennium Princess. Here is the back. Or actually, this is the front, technically, and here is the back. Either way, pretty happy about it. I really like Kaguya. We have the full art Azathoth, the full art Salamander, Ancient Magic Stone, which is pretty sweet. The, what is this, Fiery Bird of Reincarnation. I really like the shine on the back of this one. We have a Door of Time. The, what is this, Fury of the Obsidian Dragon. Which, man, this looks really cool. I really like that one quite a bit. And we have the Aya, God of Water. And last but certainly not least, Viola, Obsidian Dragon Princess, which I think looks absolutely gorgeous. Pretty happy about that one. I will probably have a full playset of this card between the two boxes. Yeah, so there you guys have it. That is my first Return of the Dragon Emperor box. There will be another one coming up soon. I hope you guys liked the video. If you did, maybe leave a like, maybe even subscribe if you have not. Every little bit helps, and I appreciate it oh so very much. Regardless of what you do, thank you very much for watching, and I hope to see you guys next time. Also, we only got 5 kimonos. We need to get more. Root for me. More kimonos. See you guys later.